once the sewer have been laid into the trenches, before covering them up, before putting them to actual use, we have to carry out some tests, which are test for alignment and straightness, water test, smoke test, and air testing is done. Okay, let's take details for alignment and straightness, in which we perform a ball test. Okay, it is a simple test. We use a spherical object, that is a ball, and we put the ball on the higher end, that is upper point, into the sewer. Okay, since there is slope present inside the sewer line, what it will do, the ball is going to roll down the sewer line. Okay, and we choose the ball size as 13 mm less than the sewer diameter. Okay, diameter of the ball will be whatever the sewer diameter is there, dia minus 13 mm will be the chosen size of the ball. Okay, in case if some obstacle is there, like this, in case some obstacle is there, it is not going to roll over smoothly. Okay, when we find that our ball is stuck in sewer, it means that a lump of mortar is there, some kind of yarn is there, some kind of garbage is there. Okay, that needs to be taken care of, that needs to be removed from the sewer before we are going to put the sewer to use. Okay, then instead of ball, what we can do, we can have two discs connected or a single solid cylinder which has diameter 75 mm less than the sewer, is put inside the sewer and it is connected with thread at the both end. Okay, then we will run that cylinder through that sewer line, and in case some obstacle is there, it is not going to run smoothly, it will not come out on the other open end. Okay, therefore we can conclude what? We can say that some kind of obstacle, some kind of mortar, yarn, or some kind of garbage or rubbish is present inside the sewer that needs to be removed. Okay, this was what? Cylinder test, option to the ball test. Okay, then another test for alignment and straightness is a mirror test. What we do? We keep one mirror at either end and we keep a source of light at other end. Now, when we illuminate the source of light, then we try to receive complete image of that light source onto the mirror. In case some obstruction is there or some problem in alignment or some problem in straightness is there, we will not be able to receive such full image into the mirror. Okay, it is going to look something like this, or we will not at all get the image from the source of light. Okay, thereby we can conclude that the alignment or straightness, whatever parameter we want to check, is not in line, is not properly carried out, is not properly maintained over there in the sewer work. Okay, that is what a mirror test. Now let's go to the water test. Now why we are doing the water test? It is done to test water tightness of the sewer. We are checking gaps, cracks, or some slit which may be there into the joint. Okay, it may be over here, or there may be a crack onto the sewer that we want to check. Okay, now when we have to carry out water test, the first thing that we should do is we should keep the whole sewer line which is meant to be tested with water. Okay, we have to fill up the whole sewer line with water, because some kind of absorption coefficient of walls of the sewer may be there, some water may get absorbed during the test. Now if some amount of water is absorbed by the walls of the sewer, there may be error while we are actually conducting the water test. That's why fill up the sewer with water, then we are going to conduct the water test. Okay, now see what we are doing in the water test. One air outlet is provided at the upper end, that is at the higher end with stopcock, in order to remove all the air in the sewer line. And another end, we fix a funnel in order to refill the water into the sewer. Okay, what we are going to do? We are going to fill the sewer with water. Okay, done, clear? Now see the procedure of water test. First of all, we will remove all the air from the sewer. Then we are going to lock the stopcock. Then we will fill up the sewer with water completely and then we are going to continue taking reading for 30 minutes. Okay, whatever the amount which is getting removed from the sewer line will be refilled through this funnel. Okay, and how much quantity of water we are going to require to replenish the level into the sewer will be noted down correspondingly. Okay, more water requirement is there, it means that some kind of leakage, some kind of gap, some kind of crack is there. Okay, therefore we can conclude that the sewer must be tested for gaps or cracks or any kind of slit which is present into the joint or on the body of the sewer itself. Okay, see, what are the standards for this water test? For small diameter pipe, the quantity of water which is required to replenish, to refill the sewer back to its original level after 30 minutes. Okay, for small diameter pipe, the quantity of water needed to replenish should not exceed 15 ml per centimeter of diameter of sewer per 100 mm length. Okay, 15 ml per centimeter of diameter of sewer per 100 mm of its length. And for large pipe, it should not exceed 60 ml per centimeter of diameter per 100 mm length. Okay, these are the standards. If these standards are not met, then what we have to do? We have to either repair the sewer. If it is not possible, we have to replace the sewer. And when we have done replacing, we have to retest the sewer for the same problem. Okay, this is how water test is conducted. Then there comes the smoke test. Now it is done for small diameter pipes, that is drainage pipes which are used in residential buildings are carried out with smoke test to test their gaps or cracks. Now what we will do, we will seal all the traps or seals which are connected to the main drainage pipe with water. Okay, then what we will do, we will use a smoke machine that makes use of oil or tar or paper to create some smoke. And after all the seals, traps are covered with water, this is supposed to be gas tight, airtight. Okay, now if the smoke is coming out of some cracks or gap, it means that we have to repair that specific spot, we have to seal that specific spot. Okay, this is how a smoke test is conducted. It is conducted at 25 mm water pressure. Okay, it is a standard pressure for smoke test. Okay, smoke test is suitable for small diameter sewer, that is drainage pipe which are present in residential or any kind of building is there. Okay, then the air test. What we do in air test, when it is not possible for two large pipe to have that much quantity of water to carry out water test, we go with air test, in which air pressure and maintenance of that air pressure in that specific sewer line is observed. Okay, what we do in this, we use a machine to fill up the sewer with air, with a gas. Okay, the gas is simply air. Okay, now what we do, we fill up air into the properly packed sewer up to 100 mm of water pressure. Okay, now we check if the pressure is maintained up to 75 mm, that is the loss of 25 mm pressure is bearable, the tolerance is 25 mm, means the initial pressure was 100 mm of water. We will see if the sewer line is maintaining 75 mm of water pressure, then it means that 25 mm tolerance level is there. If the tolerance is not met with, okay, if the losses are more than 25 mm of water pressure in terms of air maintenance into the sewer line, it means that some kind of gaps, some kind of defects are there which are beyond our tolerance limit. And now, in order to detect those specific gaps or cracks or leaks, what we will do, we will use soap water. Okay, now the tendency of soap water is to form bubble. For example, this specific spot is having some cracks or leak, and if we pour some soap water, what is going to happen, it is going to create, it is going to make bubble. Okay, it is going to create soap bubble. it is just like finding a puncture in the rubber tire of vehicle. Okay, this is how air test is conducted. Therefore, we saw four tests for testing the sewer. Okay, for alignment, for straightness, for water tightness, for air tightness. Okay, to detect joints, gaps, joint leakage or joint cracks. We had this four test. So that was all regarding testing of sewer. If you love this video, please press thumbs up. If you want to see more of such videos on this channel, please do subscribe Simplified Learning. Okay, if you want material in form of PDF, in form of notes, do subscribe to Telegram channel. And for the purest, funniest, wittiest civil engineering memes, do follow us on Instagram. Till then, take care. Bye bye.